Let's start by creating the three main functions, love.load, love.update, and love.draw. Now let's draw a rectangle. Type rectangle and then press enter. Lua love, the package we installed, turns it into the full love function, complete with the arguments. For mode, choose either fill or line, doesn't really matter. X means horizontal position of the rectangle, I is the vertical position. And then the width and the height of the rectangle. Now we have a rectangle. But how do we make it move? If we want to move it to the right, what exactly needs to happen? This number, the X position, needs to go up. 100, 101, 102, 103, etc. For this, we're going to use a variable. In love.load, make a variable called x. And let's give it a value 100. And replace the number of the x position with x. So now the x position of a rectangle is x. Now we want to make it move. We do this in the updater. Every update, we want to increase x with 5. In other words, x needs to be the value of x plus 5. And that's exactly how we write it. X equals x plus 5. So now when x is 100, it will change x into 100 plus 5. Then next update, it's 105 and x changes into 105 plus 5, etc. Run the game. You should now be able to see that rectangle is moving. But if you compare the speed of my rectangle to the speed of your rectangle, you might notice a difference. This is because not all computers update with the same speed, and that can cause problems. For example, let's say computer A runs with 100 frames per second, and computer B runs with 200 frames per second. 100 times 5 equals 500. 200 times 5 equals 1000. On computer B, the rectangle moves twice as fast. Luckily, there's a solution for this. Delta time. When love calls love.update, it passes an argument. Add the parameter dt in the love.update and print it. This argument, which we call delta time, is the time between two frames. So in computer A, which runs with 100 frames per second, delta time on average would be 1 divided by 100, which is 0.01. On computer B, delta time would be 1 divided by 200, which is 0.005. And 100 times 5 times 0.01 is the same as 200 times 5 times 0.005. So in other words, if we multiply the value we want to add to x with delta time, the rectangle will move with the same speed on all computers. So let's do that. Add times dt behind x equals x plus 5. Now it should move with the same speed on both my and your computer. But it's a bit slow, so let's change 5 to 100. And there we go, a moving rectangle. That's it for this video. In the next video, I will explain how we make it move when pressing the arrow keys. In the meantime, you can try to make the rectangle also move down. Good luck, and thanks for watching.